from Saruta. Overhand left from Balart. Saruta tries for that nice cutaway angle and throws the right. Side kick from Balart. Saruta leading with the right hand. Perhaps feels he's found a chink in the armor of El Gladiador.
Like that overhand left that Balart's throwing. He throws it from some weird angles. It's like he's a cricket bowler.
Since when do you watch cricket, Dragon?
Hey, man.
I'm impressed with that reference.
I'm out here in Singapore, bro. Good movement from both these guys. Maintaining that distance, keeping each other in the range they want. No takedowns attempted yet. We expected that from Balart, but Saruta usually shoots in quite early. But he's got to be careful of that counter left hand thrown by Balart. He's doing a good job of throwing it off his back foot, too. Nice. I would like to see Saruta start mixing in some kicks, maybe even threaten a takedown just to get Balart thinking about that takedown threat, because he has been doing so much boxing training just to sort of level up his striking game to compete with his wrestling background.
Right hand lead there from Saruta again. Balart just turns him off, goes outside leg kick.
I like the counter striking of Balart. He's doing a good job of evading the strike and then coming back ultra fast.
Balart's overhand left, trying to plant it between the eyes of Saruta. Side kick to the top of the lead knee. Oh, how about that? Fake off the right, jumping left, roundhouse kick from Balart. Saruta unsure of the unorthodox techniques coming at him so far.
Yeah, man, it's these angles coming from Balart. He is ultra fast and counter-striking well. He's going back foot really well, but then he's also attacking, mixing things up quite nicely.
High kick from Saruta. Balart just scoops it out of the way. He smiles at it. High kick from Balart. No attempt at a takedown yet from either man. Balart, short left hand, tag him on the chin. And Saruta just gets out of dodge.
Just a little tornado swinging these paws at him.
Balart, gloves up high. Mitch, we often speak about the awkwardness of fighting an opponent who's much taller than you. Is it awkward to fight an opponent who's always this much shorter than you?
I think so. I think it really plays into your distance and your range, because you're punching down rather than punching straight or punching up. And Saruta is actually used to kind of being the smaller guy in there, so he rarely fights people that are this size. So I think it's actually an advantage for Balart a lot of these cases, because people aren't used to fighting somebody his size. Nice little counter shot there. But Saruta's starting to get a little bit more active.
Saruta's looking for a takedown now. Balart stays on his feet, however. Nicely done from the Cuban. 80 seconds remains.
Balart sticks his tongue out. Let you know that, yeah, I knew that was coming, but he easily scrambles back up to his feet. But Saruta was able to get in deep. Nice left hand landed again.
Yeah, that's
by
a
Balart, but I think he just kind of stumbled backwards.
All the instructions coming from the corner of Gustavo Balart. Impressive in this opening stands up, Balart. Long reaching left hand from Saruta. His number three ranking in jeopardy tonight, Yosuke Saruta. Former world champion. Overhand left from Balart. One of his favorite weapons of the fight so far.
This fight was supposed to happen about 2 months ago, so these guys have been preparing for each other for about 16 weeks. So these guys have a lot of footage to watch on each other and really have put together some pretty good game plans. And right now, I think that Balart is slightly edging it just with that counter striking. I wouldn't mind seeing Saruta shoot him for a takedown here and just try and test things again.
Good counter overhand left there from Balart.
He's looking sharp again. Lands with the left hand. Yosuke Saruta's got to put something together right now. He has to start pushing the pace and landing some shots. I'd really like to see him start utilizing that jab. Saruta's got a beautiful jab. He's got a strong right hand. And he's got to start putting these things together.
Jumping left roundhouse kick from Balart. Flying knee from Saruta. He's tried that knee a few times, Saruta. Hoping Balart might lean into it, expose his chin. Has it happened yet?
This is where Balart's really hard to tangle with, is up against this wall. Because of his stature, it makes it tough to attack the legs. And because of his wrestling background, which is Greco-Roman, which is all upper body, you have to go after his legs, because tangling with him up top like this, this is not good for Saruta.
Planty right hook there from Balart, circles off counterclockwise, does the Cuban. There's that jumping left roundhouse kick again from Balart. Jab from Saruta. Right cross from Saruta. 3 minutes 40 remaining, second round of three.
So you can see how Balart is utilizing good footwork, right? As Saruta tries to press forward, Balart's able to backpedal just enough so that when Saruta tries to throw a strike, especially with that lead hand, Balart's out of the way and not taking any of the damage.
Counter right off the inside leg kick there from Saruta came very close for him. Nice evasion of that scooping body shot. Overhand right, Balart, good counter, short right hand from the Cuban. Gets a bit of gusto, bit of steam now, Balart on the inside. Late clinch up, good knee from Gustavo.
This is where Gustavo usually excels, but he usually just kind of holds people in this position to, you know, break away, throw a little bit of punches. Doesn't really choose to do a lot of takedown damage. I would love to see it. He's got good control of Saruta as he presses him up against the wall, has that underhook on the right side. Might be a knee tap here, but Saruta does a good job of circling away. Again, nice little counter left hand.
It's been a glorified kickboxing contest for most of it so far. Both men choosing a strike rather than look to take each other down and wrestle.
Yeah, Saruta's gonna have to get deep into a double leg, and it's probably gonna have to be in that third round where Gustavo might get a little bit tired, because right now he's really fresh. Nice combination landed by Saruta there. But that's what he's doing. See that feint that he's dropping? And it throws his head off the center line, and then he's able to counter with these shots just like that. That was beautifully timed on the left hand.
Balart, overhand, lead hand. Saruta shrugs him off, creates distance. 1:45 remains in this second round.
I would like to see Saruta start throwing uppercuts. Throw the jab, get the feint, and then boom, come up underneath with the uppercut because of the way that Balart's dipping his head.
Our main card, folks, just minutes away. We've got six fights on that main card, including two world titles in a double main event.
Saruta's trying to push forward, pawing out with that left hand. Gustavo's, again, see, he's timing, he's waiting. This is where Saruta could attack the lead leg or even start just touching out that jab, getting a reaction, trying to throw more feints.
They are going absolutely crazy now in Saruta's corner. A little bit of blood trickling down the left cheek of the Japanese fighter. Nothing to be concerned about, however. Weight into the body off that right hand. Has Balart slowed down here, Dragon?
He slowed down a bit, you know. This is a pretty frantic pace that these guys are pushing. Nice left hand landed by Saruta there. You can see Balart's not throwing as much, especially with these counter shots. This is where Saruta can start to draw things out of him. See, that's the inside leg kick. That's what he needs to keep going to. Lots of feints coming from Saruta now. I like how he's utilizing the feints just to create a little bit of reaction out of Balart. Saruta's starting to excel here in the later parts of this round. Nice left hook, big landed by Balart. This is where Saruta could land possibly a takedown. This is a huge opportunity for Balart, and he needs to seize it right now, because if he can capture a win over the former champion, Yosuke Saruta, this will catapult him into the top five.
High kick from Saruta. looping punch from Balart. Will Balart go for that jumping left roundhouse kick he's been using? Nice gut munching knee from the Cuban.
Look at Balart attempting a double leg takedown, but good defense from Yosuke Saruta. I think this match could be anybody's game right now, especially in these last 4 minutes. Whoever can put their foot down and really make a huge statement might be able to take it.
A punt kick there from Saruta. Shoots in.
Oh, that was nice. Jumped around, took the back. But Balart has such a low center of gravity, it's so tough to get an advantageous position on him to grapple.
Is that another advantage of being such a short fighter, having that lower center of gravity?
It has to be, especially with those legs. Look at him. They're so stocky and stout.
You might be so strong, don't you?
Yeah.
Football.
Oh, he caught it!
Beautifully done from Balart, off the left hand. Here comes El Gladiador. Here comes the Cuban. High knee! He's coming forward now, hoping for a finish.
Wow, Yosuke Saruta ate it. This is aiding Saruta right now. He's got good takedown defense. Look at Saruta. Beautifully defends the single leg.
Saruta's number three ranking in jeopardy.
That was huge, Michael, right there.
And I think it may have broken Saruta's nose.
Just leaking out of his face.
He's a mess right now. The former world champion against the out of top five, Gustavo Balart. With under 3 minutes remaining.
Man, again, it was that left counter hand he threw, the counter left hand, sorry. Ducked his head, boom, came across with that huge left.
The blood you see on the shoulder of Balart is Saruta's blood. The nose may be broken.
Saruta take a long break, immediately shoots in for that double leg. Great defense from Balart. Balart needs to capitalize on that huge left hand that he landed. And Saruta needs to work his way back into this match, Michael.
This would be a huge win, the biggest win for Gustavo Balart. Trying to thread that overhand right, Gustavo. There's the overhand left from the Cuban. Round kick to the upper right rib cage. Overhand left again from Balart. Overhand left once more. Hoping to bring it down on that cracked nose. Look at a bludgeon in the face of Saruta. Oh, Balart continues to push forward with that left. Shakes his head. Says he's got to do better than that fella. Saruta, who seemed full of confidence of beating the Cuban. I think he's received a shot tonight.
Good takedown defense from Balart. I like the way he uses his head to get underneath the head of Saruta to pry him up and to defend quite well. Look at Saruta trying to press forward, realizes the urgency of the situation.
Big looping right to left hand combination. There's another overhand left from Balart. 1 minute remaining in the fight now. Balart comes forward, telegraphs that overhand left. Hoping for one big knockout punch is Gustavo Balart to send him into the top five of the strawweight division.
Right now, after that knockdown, look at these shots. The way that he wings these overhand punches is really difficult to see. He's touching Saruta. Might not hit him cleanly, but when he does hit him cleanly, Saruta feels it, as we saw earlier.
Folks, our main card just moments away. And part of it, we will determine the number one contender in the strawweight division for Joshua Pastrio's crown when Volkan Masuniano takes on Jared Brooks. Final seconds, still looping the punches is Balart. It looks like we're going down to the judges. Balart backs him off with the left. High knee from Saruta, last elbow, and we are deemed going to decision.